Hey guys, Walla here. If you were not aware, Trials actually did return today. So today's going to be a Trials related video, and it's going to be about Adept weapons. Before we get into that though, I want to thank you guys so much for almost 20,000 subscribers, man. Holy cow. Thank you guys for anyone who's been tuning into the videos, tuning into the live streams. I really do appreciate it. Thank you guys for everything, seriously. So this time around, Trials has different rewards. It's still the same old rewards from before, but you can now get Adept weapons and Adept armor pieces and Adept mods. Some of you may know, some of you may not know what these are, but we'll get into that in a second. These Adept weapons and Adept armor, we haven't gotten an Adept armor piece yet, but I can say the Adept weapons are, they're better than the original ones without a doubt. Like it's statistically better, but they're not that much better, and I'll show you guys here right now. All right, so here we have the summoner, the Adept version of the summoner, actually. Some of you may already notice a little difference from the Adept version, and that's good if you do, but I'm going to go over it right now. So excluding the perks, we don't have to worry about the perks here. The main difference between Adept version and non-Adept versions is the fact that when you fully masterwork the gun, you get the stability bonus, so that's the biggest chunk you get. And actually, every other stat goes up as well, I'm pretty sure by 5. I'll put on screen if that's correct or not, but range goes up, stability goes up the most since we got a stability masterwork, handling goes up a little bit, and reload speed a little bit. And that's pretty good, that's awesome. You know, it's like armor pieces now. You know, when you masterwork an armor piece, every single tier goes up as well, right? So that's pretty damn cool. And I'll get into why I don't really see myself grinding for Adept weapons here. So that's cool, right? Technically, this is already better than the original one, which is awesome. But now you guys are wondering, well, is that it? No, that's not it, right? There's also Adept mods. So here you have Adept targeting, and obviously we have normal targeting as well, the targeting adjuster mod. And you might be wondering, like, okay, well, why are you not so happy with the Adept mods, right? Like this looks pretty awesome. You guys got to remember now, the Adept mods go in the same slot as your old mods. So someone like me who uses Icarus on quite literally any gun in the game, it's kind of like, wait a second, hold on. I can't use Icarus. You know, it's just, so basically for someone like me, who's not going to use an Adept mod because I use Icarus on everything, right? So the only virtual difference is the fact that I get tiny boosts on every single stat, and that's it, right? There are some of you that don't use Icarus, but this would be awesome for you, right? Like, yo, I got, you know, you got a summoner now with, you know, a little bit extra perks, and you get Adept mods. I'm going to show you guys all the Adept mods in a second, but this one, for example, this Adept mod doesn't even work for mouse and keyboard, right? Targeting adjuster or Adept targeting, they don't work, right? Because we don't have aim assist on mouse and keyboard. So this is already a useless perk for me. And on top of the fact that it actually comes at a cost, right? It's a cost to stability. So the way I see it right now, assuming even if I was on a controller, let's say I used Icarus on a controller normally, I would have to sacrifice Icarus to put the targeting, the Adept targeting on. And not only am I getting, you know, I get more target acquisition, yeah, but I sacrifice stability for it. And in my mind, it's just like, I can't shoot in the air now, and I have less stability. For what, right? Like for a little bit more, like how much better is it more? How much more better is it than targeting adjuster, really, right? To be sacrificing that much stability. It's just, it's not something I really look forward to using. And I honestly, I'm not going to use any Adept mods, assuming I need Icarus on everything, right? So that's just my personal take on it. I know what some of you are thinking, okay? Well, of course they have to remove like a certain stat, right? Like you have to remove some stability for more target acquisition. That's the only way to balance it, stuff like that. And I agree with you, right? Like I would normally agree with you, but the fact that the Adept mods go into the same slot as the normal mods, you're not only losing the fact that you're not only losing stability, but you're also losing the fact that you can't shoot in the air now. For those of us who use Icarus, especially on PC, it's a pretty damn popular mod, right? A lot of us do use Icarus, and now we can't shoot in the air, and we have to sacrifice more stability for something like if you use that perk, but there are other perks here or other mods I'm going to show you guys here on the screen now. I don't want you guys to be fooled, okay? Not every single one of these Adept mods can go on every single weapon. For example, Adept draw time obviously only goes on a bow, right? and stuff like that. Like a depth projectile speed only goes on a grenade launcher, stuff like that, or a rocket launcher. You know, I just want to make sure we're on the same page for that. But if you look at stuff like adept counterbalance, for example, right? For some people who use counterbalance, greatly improves recoil direction at the cost of range, right? Does that sound good to you? Like, does that really sound good to anybody? Range is so important in this game, on top of the fact that normal counterbalance is already pretty damn good on its own. So why would you use, like, yeah, you get a little bit more stability, but at the cost of range, it's not worth it, right? And stuff like, you know, adept handling sounds pretty good. You get more handling, right? Adept impact for swords. There's no downside to those perks, right? And stuff like that. But if you use those adept mods, you can't use Icarus. And again, it literally always comes down to Icarus. You need Icarus. It's so important in this game because of how much you're jumping and how important it is to be mobile in this game, right? And I know a lot of people, not everybody is always in the air and stuff. And for those people, these adept weapons are actually pretty damn good for you, right? If you use something like adept range and you have like a range masterwork on top of that, that would be freaking awesome. You know, you have so much more range now. But for those of us who need Icarus in our playstyles, it's going to be terrible because there's virtually no difference besides the fact that we can masterwork it for extra stats, like a little bit more stats. That's about it, right? So what do I want? What was I expecting? Okay. What I was expecting personally is I was expecting two different mod slots. I was expecting one normal mod slot and one adept mod slot, but not for every weapon, right? I don't want you guys to get confused. I would expect this from, like, you know, a trials only adept weapon, like that has two mod slots, something that feels, you know, like super, like, not, you know, just feels exclusive to, you know, trials, because you worked your ass off to get it, right? So I was expecting to keep the mod for, like, you know, a normal mod, so you can have Icarus, and then you could have an adept mod on top of that. So, like, you could have, like, adept range on top of it, you know, with no downside at all. And some of you might be thinking, dude, that sounds overpowered, but is it really that, like, it's not gonna be that crazy. It's gonna feel more, you know, more prestigious, I guess. Like, it's, or, you know, it's gonna feel like it was worth the grind going flawless, because right now the adept weapons really don't feel that much more special than the normal ones, right? Especially if you're always gonna be using Icarus anyways, you're getting like what, like 15 more stat bonus. That's about it, right? So it does suck. I definitely would have went, I would have liked that approach much better, but I can understand some people thinking it would have been a lot, you know, too overpowered or whatever. But in reality, like, I don't see it really being that much, you know, better. Other than that, I'm still pretty excited for the adept stuff, like adept mods and all that. Like, I'm pretty excited for stuff like that. Nonetheless, even after what I've said, I know a lot of people are going to enjoy the adept weapons because not everybody uses Icarus. You know, I understand everyone has different playstyles, and this is just for me and a lot of other people that I know use Icarus. So this is just how we feel and how I feel like they could have gone about the adept weapons a little differently. But, you know, other than that, I'm still pretty excited. I'm definitely going to try and get all the adept weapons still. And, yeah, for those that are interested, I do stream trials every single weekend on twitch.tv/Walla. I play with people like Panda and stuff. So if you're trying to watch some of that, I'll put the link right in front of your face, and I'll put it in the description as well. I would appreciate it if you could give me a follow. And, yeah, thank you guys so much for all the support, man. I'm trying to put a video out every day, trying to stream whenever I can. So I really do appreciate everyone helping me out. Thank you guys so much. And, with that, I hope everyone has a good night, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Peace out, boys. Bye.